pick up the saxophone. You should look and the thing works. Before you start to pray, this should be checked. Make sure this closes. You know, this is very important because sometimes open. Always lock this. It should be with space. If there is no space, you just have to hold this key and bend this key up very gently. And always on the A key to test so that this is perfect. You can play the A and go, yeah, replace the B flat. In other words, use the third finger to press down the A, and with the middle finger you touch the bass key. Now, there's a big movement that goes around.
I thought that with the tape.
It goes out adjustment. You know, easy. Then you go to the next or G sharp. Now, also here, G sharp at the same time. I think you get two different sounds like that means here, G sharp it comes up. So, if it comes up to string noise, you to use the screw, just put a little piece masking tape underneath the screw here, on top of the key, and try it again. Maybe you may need two pieces, or maybe one piece. That's a problem here for those three notes on the bottom. And that's the way you test it. See, if I do this, it's good to put a little, maybe old English lemon oil.
On any pads or just your treated pads?
Any pads. Yeah. You know, lemon oil is very clean oil. You can put it on the edge. So that, you know, that sometimes the toner will build up a lot of dust. So when the pad won't close, you know, gentle. See, so this will clean nice. It'd be good to do maybe once a month, once every 2 months to clear the pads. You know, that's all you have to do. See, it's much better. Because the pads, they get dry, they get hard.
And you use a brush like that for the lemon oil?
Yeah, a little brush. I don't mean a big brush like this. You can get a little brush, small.
Mm-hmm.
And you give them, in other words, by doing this, you give more life to the pads. And then you get something like this.
Uh-huh.
What this is transformation oil. I use them, you see?
Yes, just transmission oil.
Yeah. I mean, if you want to use transmission, it should be a little more heavy oil. Like you can buy rotary valve oil for rotary trombone. That's as I do here. Turn around and do the right hand, you see? Here. As you press, sometimes you go brrrr. So if you put a little heavy oil here.
Does that help with loose rollers too? That make noise?
Yes.
Or you need to do something else to it?
Yeah, but they're going to be rolled. It flows out. So I won't go brrr.
Right. And you just use, what kind of oil again, you said?
Well, I like transmission oil, so it's very clean. But also, if you don't want to do that, the drop is to stay on the nail. It comes like that.
Gotcha. That's the thickness.
Yeah, the oil is to stay on it. I can't see. And make sure you lock the screws, especially the bottom ones, this rod, sometimes it comes out, and then the deal wiggle. Just lock the saxophone, lock at it, to lock. You can lock out like this, and underneath. Turn around, lock the rods, that's it. But there's also more to talk, I won't say every day, but every time you pick up the saxophone, you should lock anything works, especially this, it's a problem. Because you handle all the time, when you play with the pressure, you play the neck or something. You play, but you gotta blow hard. And again, I'll repeat the way you fix it. Bend it. If you do too much, then you bend down. The play this, it stays open. Some people do one in the neck like this, like that, like this. So they'll say, what's the autumn key? So it closes. If you like the position, the neck like this, it should be.
Very good, Emilio.